Dear students, today we will solve one example in chapter issue of bonus shares, subject advanced accounting and auditing, paper 4, class second year BCom, semester 4, Veer Narmad South Gujarat University. Here is the question. The following balances are shown in the books of Manan Company. Equity share capital of rupees 10 each, rupees 9 per share paid up, rupees 18 lakh. Securities premium rupees 40,000. Profit prior to incorporation rupees 60,000. Capital redemption reserve rupees 1,60,000. And profit and loss account credit balance rupees 1,40,000. The Manan Company declares a bonus to make their partly paid up shares as fully paid up. Give the necessary journal entries in the books of the company for bonus shares. Dear students, let us understand the question. Here we are given informations of a company, Manan Limited. Equity share capital of rupees 10 each, rupees 9 per share paid up, and total paid up value is 18 lakh. So number of shares issued by company would be rupees 18 lakh divided by rupees 9 per share, so it will be 2 lakh equity shares. And as a reserve and surplus, we have securities premium, profit prior to incorporation, capital redemption reserve, and profit and loss account. So out of this reserve, company plans to make their partly paid up shares fully paid up by giving them bonus. So first of all, we will decide the reserves to be utilized for issue of bonus. Securities premium, as per the rules and provisions for issue of bonus shares, securities premium can be utilized only for fully paid up bonus shares. So here security premium is not available for bonus shares, because our shares are partly paid up. Face value of rupees 10 each, rupees 9 per share paid up. That's why our shares are partly paid up. And securities premium cannot be utilized for giving bonus to make partly paid up shares fully paid up. Our second reserve and surplus is profit prior to incorporation. This is available for issue of bonus to partly paid up shares. Capital redemption reserve is not available for partly paid up shares. And profit and loss account credit balance is a free reserve available for partly paid up shares bonus. Now let us work out the bonus amount. First, here are the basic calculations. First of all, we decide number of equity shares issued by company. So it is total paid up capital divided by paid up per shares, rupees 18 lakh divided by rupees 9. So total shares issued by company, company 2 lakh equity shares. Number 2, final call due on equity shares issued, that is 2 lakh equity shares multiply rupee 1, that is face value rupees 10 minus paid up value rupees 9, rupee 1. So amount of final call is rupees 2 lakh. So if company wants to make partly paid up shares fully paid up, company need to issue bonus of rupees 2 lakh. And therefore, in step number 3, our bonus amount is equal to final call due is equal to rupees 2 lakh. Students, always remember, for partly paid up bonus shares, bonus amount is equal to final call due on shares. Here in our example, it is rupees 2 lakh. And final step, we will make provision for bonus. So out of profit prior to incorporation, amount will be utilized rupees 60,000. And out of profit and loss account credit balance, amount will be utilized rupees 1,40,000. So total amount rupees 2 lakh, which is equal to bonus amount. And now we will pass journal entries to record the transactions of issue of bonus shares. Here are the journal entries in the books of the company for issue of bonus shares. Our first entry is for utilization of free reserve or for making provision of bonus amount. An entry is profit prior to incorporation account debit rupees 60,000, profit and loss account debit rupees 1,40,000, to shareholders bonus account rupees 2 lakh. Here we are utilizing the reserves, free reserves, and that's why reserves are debited, and bonus to be paid to shareholders, that's why shareholders bonus account is credited. Our second entry for final calls due on equity shares. So entry is share final call account debit rupees 2 lakh to equity share capital account rupees 2 lakh. And third entry for issue of bonus to make partly paid up shares fully paid up. And our accounting entry is shareholders bonus account debit to share final call account rupees 2 lakh. That's all. Now dear students, you can check shareholders bonus account was credited in first entry and the same account was debited in third entry. So account gets closed. Tally. Okay. So like this, company may issue bonus to make its partly paid up equity shares fully paid up. And for making partly paid up fully paid shares by issuing bonus, company utilizes only and only free reserves. Securities premium and capital redemption reserves are not available for partly paid up bonus shares. Dear students, thank you very much for watching this video lecture. Very soon we will meet with another example in the same chapter.